Hey guys, thanks for joining Willie Outdoors. I'm here with my wife. Today is Friday, the 23rd. We are at Spruce Knob, Monongahela National Forest in West Virginia. It's my first time here, but second time for Gretchen. She's gonna show me around and we're gonna check it out, you know? So thanks for joining and watching. Okay, we started hiking the trail 533. This is the Huckleberry Trail. Nice pine forest. Following the blue diamond blazes, and there's a lot of nice campsites. All right, we already hiked about a mile and a half through these nice pine forest. Got a nice trail. Uh-oh, you okay there, babe? Oh, there's plenty of campsites at the Huckleberry Trail. So far so good. I forgot to mention earlier, we're gonna do two overnight. Right now it's about the high 60s, we'll probably go low 50 more or less, and we're gonna hike about 6 miles or a little over 6 miles and try to find a campsite on Seneca Creek for tonight. Nice rocky trail. We're about 3.5 miles in. We're descending little by little. Beautiful pine forest. It's the Huckleberry Trail, 533 to our left. campsite over there. Okay, we made it to the Lumberjack 534 trail. We got the Horton and the Huckleberry Spruce Knob Tower. We're here at the Horton Trail. We're gonna go down this valley and connect to Judy Springs. It's absolutely beautiful. Well, all the leaves, most of the leaves are already have fallen up here. We came from up there. Beautiful cloudy day. Probably about, it's gotta be close to 70, high 60s. We are in Judy Springs. And we made it to Seneca Creek. Got some campers up there, over there, close to the creek. Thank you. And we're on the Sanger Creek Trail. We'll hike for another hour or so and find a camp spot. Okay, we found a sweet campsite right next to Seneca Creek. We got a nice luxury stone fire pit with a stone love seat over there. A table, a couple of extra stone chairs. Gretchen's already laid out in her chameleon. The creek is right next to us. Right along Seneca Creek. I already have my chameleon Dutch Skull's hammock, the winter tarp, I mean winter cover. Yeah, we're gonna finish settling in, and it's about 6 p.m. We did a little over 6 miles, and we'll start getting some dinner ready and eat some dinner. We have fire for tonight. Gretchen's boiling some water for dinner. Get this party started. Oh yeah. We got about half a moon over there. Nice clear blue skies. All right, it's 7:30. We're enjoying the fire tonight. And for dinner, we're having some Willie's chili. And we're about to mess this all up here and enjoy dinner. This after dinner, just to enjoy the fire for a little bit, as long as the wood lasts. Enjoy watching the stars. I don't know if you can see it. Yeah, it's too dark. Enjoy the night, and I think we'll call it a night. I guess hiker midnight rolls in around 8 or 9, I guess. We'll see. But other than that, it was a great hike today, and all right, we'll catch you guys tomorrow morning. Have a good night, guys. Good morning, guys. It's Saturday. It's about 8, a little after 8:30. I've just gotten up at 7:30 this morning. Didn't sleep well, slept on and off, but anyway, I think it started raining at 4:30 this morning, but so far so good. It stopped, didn't last long. It was probably some passing showers, but anyway, we're having breakfast right now. Gretchen is filtering some water. I got some coffee made and have a like an oatmeal bar for breakfast. And then we're gonna go check out the big waterfalls that's nearby. Should be about a mile or so. And then we'll come back to camp, break down and head back to close to the car, but we'll find a campsite on our way back, maybe 4 or 5 miles. But catch you later. Good morning, Gretchen. How did you sleep last night?
I slept well. I slept probably till 2 solid, and then on and off after that. The rain woke me up as well. It was windy and it was loud, but I slept well.
Yeah, but better than me. I'm glad at least somebody got some sleep. Yeah, but we are right next to Seneca Creek. It looks like the rain cleared out. It feels like in the 60s. Doesn't feel like cool. It actually feels nice. We had our neighbors over there. They packed up and left already. But yeah, this is a very nice campsite. Right along the creek, Seneca Creek. As you can see, we were gonna get a spot at the first falls we bumped into, but some people already beat us to it, but that's fine.
I guess the trail is a little flat, so.
And we made it to Seneca Falls. We are all packed up. Left the campsite clean. And we're ready to rock and roll. Oh yeah, this was a nice campsite. But sad, we have to keep on trucking. And we are at the Lumberjack Trail. We're gonna try and find the plane crash and have some lunch and then turn around and head back to Huckleberry and find a campsite for tonight. All right, we just came back from the Lumberjack Trail. Couldn't find a plane crash, so we just decided to head back and we're gonna hike and try to get a campsite for tonight. About 2 miles back towards the car. And get to hike these hills up here. Let me show you. We made it to camp. This is our second night. We found a campsite off the Huckleberry Trail. And we did a little over 6 miles today, including the Seneca Falls. And this campsite is really nice here too. I got Gretchen, she's taking a nap. Today's a little cooler. There's a breeze going on. Probably the temperature's gonna drop tonight. It'll be probably a little cooler tonight than yesterday. We'll see. And we got plenty of wood here. I'm gonna start a fire. And then later on, we'll have some dinner. Overall, we got a nice little pine forest campsite here, and then over there is the Huckleberry Trail, and we should be about 2 miles to the parking lot, which we'll hike out tomorrow morning. Anywho, start a campfire to keep warm for tonight. All right, it's about 6:40. We got a fire going on, and we're getting ready to go have some dinner. We got some rehydrated lentil loaf. We added some instant mashed potatoes, and then Gretchen made some rehydrated mushrooms, tomatoes. It's Thanksgiving up in here. Oh yeah, save the best for last. Got Gretchen doing her Instagram pics for her, you know, for her food ink. And yeah, just having a good night. Our last night here. We'll head out tomorrow. Still a little bit daylight, as you can see. But pretty soon it'll be pitch black over here. We've had a good, wonderful two-nighter here. Well, so far, so good. We have some dinner. Enjoy the bonfire. Maybe call it a night later on. If not, have a good night, guys. Good morning, guys. It's Sunday morning. we're all packed up, getting ready to go to the parking lot, and we're going to check out Spruce Knob, the highest point West Virginia. But in the meantime, that was our campsite last night. We had a good fire. Our campsite here, leave no trace, left it nice and clean. Some extra firewood for the next happy campers, and we're out. It's a little chilly this morning. Probably in the 50s, but we're gonna start hiking now. We only got about 2.2 miles to the parking lot, so it won't be that bad. So here we go. Beautiful trail back to the car. All right, one more thing. I slept better last night than the night before, so that's good. It's nice and quiet. Had some rain this morning. Luckily it stopped, so anyway, catch you later. And we made it back to the parking lot. It's a little misty, foggy today. And we did a total of about a little over 15 miles, about 16. Two-nighter.
Awesome trip with my baby.
Awesome trip with my wifey. It was a good, nice getaway weekend. Very relaxing. We're gonna now check out Spruce Knob, the highest point of West Virginia. Spruce Knob, highest elevation of 4863. Let's go check it out. It's kind of misty, so I probably won't have much of a view. Made it to the Spruce Knob Tower. Unfortunately, it's all misty and foggy. You can't see anything. But this is the highest point of West Virginia, Spruce Knob. There's probably better views when it clears up, but this is all I can get. No, it's too bad it's misty and foggy. Can't see much. But I bet those are the views right there.